Let's open our Bible in the book of Psalms. Psalms chapter 37, verse 33. But the Lord will not let the wicked succeed, or let the godly be condemned when they are put on trial. Clap our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. The Lord said the wicked will not succeed in their plans in our lives. And then the godly will not be weighed down, will not be destroyed by their trials. Amen.
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 Are we communicating? Amen. Can I hear louder?
Amen.
Our God sees the wicked one will not succeed in our lives. He will not succeed with his wickedness in our... No matter what they are doing. If God says they will not succeed, that means what? God has put on measures that the wicked should never succeed their plans in our lives in Jesus' name. And the Lord said the godly shall not be destroyed by the trouble they go through. The who? The godly. Godly means believers. People that have repented. God's own people. So you need to be very careful in this message. God separated and said the godly or all people on earth. The godly shall not be destroyed. Amen. So if you are a godly, if you are a believer, and you are going through a situation, it should be telling you that trial will not destroy you. Are you understanding now? When you understand it like that, you become very, very straightened. He said the godly will not do what? They will not? The godly will not be destroyed by what? I want you to read it in your Bible. Read from your Bible. He said, but the godly will not. Read it in another version. I want us to understand it well.
Psalms chapter 37, verse 33. Here you read, but the Lord will not leave them in the powers of the wicked, or let them be condemned when brought to trials. Amen.
Are you getting it? God will not allow his people in the power of the wicked shall not do what? The wicked shall not do what? The wicked shall not. The wicked shall not succeed. Clap for Lord Jesus Christ. There is an assurance that God Almighty has given us. That during the time they are attacking you, he knows, he sees, but that attack will yield no fruit to the kingdom of darkness. So when you are facing an attack, be brave. Be what? Be brave. God is with us. Why are they attacking you? Because of godliness. Because of what? Godliness in you. They see light, they come to attack. But one thing is very sure, that attack will not wear us out. It's just for a while. Some attacks God allowed them to come to us. Why? God has never said you will not be attacked. You will be attacked, but victory is assured. Tell the neighbor there will be a battle, but victory is assured. There is a battle, but victory is assured. So that is how it is. He said, these weapons of this warfare, our weapons of warfare are not coming from us. They are mighty in God to the pulling down of every stronghold. He did not say pulling down of attacks, but pulling down of bigger attacks. Stronghold means what? Stronghold means what? Bigger attacks. What is the meaning? Our weapons of warfare are not carnal. They are not from us. That means every attack, the weapons we use in it are not coming from us. That means God is ready at all times to plunge weapons, to send missiles into the camp of the enemy when we call upon him. See, the weapons of who is in the warfare? Are you understanding? Who is in the warfare? Who is not God? Who is in the warfare? Who is facing the war? It's not God. God does not face war. Who is facing the war? Who is that? Who is facing the war? Until you understand, that's why you're not understanding. Who is facing the war? Human being, not God. Are you hearing now? So, but God said, you are weapons of this warfare will not come from you. They are in the hands of God. You don't understand the scripture, that's why you cannot use it well. When you are in the battle and God knows where that human being is in the is where? Is in the battle. So he said, okay, you are on earth, you are in the battle, but the weapons of this battle are not with you. They are in heaven. That means at all times God is hearing. He's listening at us, watching at us. To do what? To send weapons in the face of a warfare. Amen. Now when you look at it clearly, you see that what? The Lord said the wicked shall not succeed in their plan. That means when the wicked one launch war against you, God will prevent them from succeeding in their own plan. But God made it clear, the godly. Tell somebody the godly. Tell somebody the godly. Godly are when during a warfare. If you are listening to me, can I see your hand up? I want everybody to hear this now. Clap for Jesus Christ. During a warfare, during a warfare, tell your neighbor, during a warfare, first thing, listen, first thing the enemy first analyzes you. The enemy does what? Analyzes you.
It analyses d'abord.
Looking for what? Accusation.
Une accusation.
Looking for what? Accusation. Une what he will accusation. Use to accuse you. If not, there is nothing he can do in your life.
Sinon, y'a rien qu'il puisse faire contre ta vie.
Am I talking to somebody here?
Est-ce que je parle à quelqu'un ici?
The first weapon of Satan against a believer is accusation. Is what?
C'est l'accusation.
Is what?
C'est quoi?
Accusation.
Accusation.
He analyzes.
Il analyse d'abord.
Looks you around. What is the evil thing you have done?
Quelles sont les choses mauvaises que tu fais?
What is it that you are doing which is not in the line of God's plan?
Qu'est-ce qu'il fait qui n'est pas dans le plan de Dieu?
What are the mago that you are doing?
Quelles sont les vices de
if Satan analyzes,
si Satan les analyse
and does not see one thing,
et qu'il ne voit pas une chose,
it's a tough battle. It goes.
Ça devient une bataille
just
difficile.
Because that kind of a man,
parce que ce
just one word you release,
une seule parole que tu relâches,
pull down thousands of demons.
Des milliers de
that's why the Bible says the prayer of a righteous man has. What is the meaning? It shows that a righteous man, God is fully with you. God is what? God is fully with you. So he said the godly, he will not allow the enemy to succeed. And during a problem, during a battle, there is another thing you need to understand. After accusation, Satan comes to minister. He will minister to you to do what? Drop down your faith. To do what? Because if your faith is strong, you will not succeed. If he analyzes and sees that you are not magumagoing, you are okay with God, you are righteous with God, the next thing is to work out your faith. Is to do what? Work out now your faith. If he succeeds to drop your faith, it is another problem that he can attack you successfully. Faith makes a man so strong. Faith makes a man do what? So strong. What people are seeing impossible, you are seeing it possible. Amen? Because of your faith in God. You will really start with faith. But because of satanic ministration, you give up on the way. And when you give up on the way, spirit does not give up. Tell somebody, spirit does not give up. Tell somebody, spirit does not give up. Until they are casted away. By the time you are trying to give up, during a deliverance, you heard that demon confess that they are always on attack. Always fighting. The whole meeting every night. Demonic people don't rest. Do you know that? The Bible has made it to us to know. Demonic people does not rest. They are restless like the wave of a sea. So, man to pray, you should not rest. You should not do what? We are talking of a trial situation here. God said, in that trial, you will not be weighed down. During a trial, Satan comes first. He tries to make sure that he sees an accusation. No accusation, he fights now your faith. If he's fighting your faith and he cannot succeed, it ends the battle there, there and there. What you are hearing takes place in chronoseconds. It's not something that, no, just now, pop, 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 pop. It has done. That is how quick it becomes. If you fight your faith and it doesn't work, it disappears. But it doesn't give up. It doesn't do what? It comes again trying. If it comes and tries like three times, it doesn't succeed, he will send a bigger demon now. This is the center of believers. What we are talking about. When your belief in God is strengthened, your faith is also elevated. And when your faith is elevated, your productivity too is also elevated. Because you always deploy God in everything you are doing. And when you deploy God in everything you are doing, there is nothing that can fail in your life. You try, if it doesn't work, it's not because you are failed, but God is reserving you for a better life. Because what your eyes are seeing might not be good for you, but it's good unto God. Amen. So not every success in our life God will apply it. Not everything we need God will apply it. Not like that. There are many things you pray. Desire with your heart that God should do it. God is hearing. He's hearing. It's not happening while God doesn't want to do it. Because it is not good for his people. Amen. So God will always give us what we need and not what we want. Amen. So in the face of a problem, some of us run into problem because of our ways. Because of what? Our ways. There are certain things, listen and listen well. There are certain things that you were not doing. The Spirit of God rejected that kind of a thing. Satan kept on ministering, reminding that same thing to you, maybe for 1 year. Maybe you can do that for 1 year even. You are escaping that very thing. But after some time, the administration start working. You start doing that very thing that you did not want to do. Why? Satan's ministration now is working in your life. Amen. And when you disobey now God, and you are doing something which is evil, listen, are you still a godly? Are you still a godly? You are not more a godly. He said the godly, not the what? So when Satan comes to attack the godly, he makes sure that the godly should not be godly before they are attacked. Because once you continue remaining a godly, this word of God must take place in your life. That says what? The godly shall not be destroyed. There will be trials. They are there. The trials, when they always comes, most of the time we escape. But don't worry. There are certain things Satan will do to reinforce the trial. When he reinforces the trial, you will see the need to do that very thing that you did not want to do. Am I talking to somebody here? Listen and listen well. There's something the Spirit of God kept on telling you not to do. You were very careful about, and you know that that thing is not good. It's not godly. You kept it. No, I will not do it. And even God revealed to you, make you know that that thing is not good. Everything else is not good. Satan knows.
Satan le sait.
That very thing, you are very aware of it.
Que vous êtes conscient de cette chose.
It will cause another thing somewhere.
Il va causer quelque chose ailleurs.
To shake in you.
Vous
and reinforce the temptation.
Il va forcer la tentation.
When it reinforces the temptation,
lorsque la tentation
and you are not still standing,
et que vous ne vous tenez pas,
you will fall into that trap.
Vous allez tomber dans son piège.
Remember.
Rappelez-vous.
Adam's temptation was who? Was through Eve. It was through Eve. Eve was not enough to be used for that very temptation. Was she enough? Was she enough? They have to reinforce now the temptation by what? By what? By the serpent. Remember that Adam already told Eve, and all of them knew. Remember what? Adam already told Eve about that tree, and all of them knew. Do you know how long they were staying there bare body? Come, I don't have somebody here. Do you know they were staying in the garden for some time? Bare body? Eh?
Eh?
Why were they staying? Because Eve was in obedience. To what God spoke to Adam, and Adam told Eve. That temptation, Satan kept on turning around. Kept on doing what? Turning around. We don't know how many years they lived in the garden before Satan finally reinforced the temptation through what? The snake. So that thing standing in your camp, struggling to make you sin, if you don't deal with it well, you will finally catch up with it someday. You finally do it, catch up with it someday. For me, most of the time, I like dealing with the thing straight.
Qui me concerne, moi,
I like eradicating that thing from my territory.
J'aime éradiquer cette chose aussitôt de mon territoire.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes. I like eradicating that thing from my territory.
J'aime éradiquer cette chose de mon territoire.
But if it is what God wants it to be that they will use,
mais c'est la volonté de
that thing is valuable to you. Am I talking to somebody here? It's valuable to you.
Ça vous est valable.
But they want to use it.
On veut l'utiliser.
Like Adam could not drive away Eve.
That means so,
he was bound to live with Eve because Eve is a and he loved Eve. He loved Eve. So he could not drive away Eve. So but Eve was a channel for Satan to use. So what do you do there? You need to always lift up your tongue to pray on that place. If you cannot be good away with the thing, cover that place with it. And when you try for some time, it doesn't work, they will flee. Now, do what? They will never jubilate in your case in Jesus' name. I said the evil one will never jubilate in your case in Jesus' name. Because when man finally gives in to Satan, there is jubilation in their kingdom. There is what? Jubilation in their kingdom. And when you give it, you don't know what they wanted to collect in your life. They can be targeting your business, but presenting you a young girl. I'm talking to somebody here. That girl is, you are married though. Are you getting some secrets? You are what? I'm talking to somebody here. You are what? Married. They can be targeting your business.
Vous êtes marié, on peut cibler vos affaires.
And you are married.
Et vous êtes marié.
They bring a young girl, begin to talk, blah blah blah, laughing with your hair. And it is telling you that that girl is up to something.
Et quand c'est baptisé avec cette fille quelque chose.
You know it.
Cette fille est envoyée.
Can you not know?
Est-ce que vous n'allez pas savoir?
Where are the men? Can you not know it?
Où sont les hommes? Est-ce que vous ne savez pas?
You don't know say that girl, eh?
Vous ne savez pas que cette fille.
She laughs with you laugh with her. She laughs with you, you laugh with her. Love you so. You don't know that they are placing that girl to make you go away from the camp of the godly. Immediately, that girl laughs with you too much and you eat fufu with her. And you fall with her. That is how your empire is gone. Your business is gone.
You
pull down your finances. Pull down your contracts. Pull down this. They must not attack you in the place they want to destroy. No. They can be bringing the temptation from far. From where? From far. Now, when the godly is under trial, take some time of prayer. God allows some trials in our lives to bring us nearer to Him. Say anymore. God allows some trials. I cannot hear you well. In the life of believers, to bring us nearer to Him. Yes. There are some people that are even here today, yes. That you came to service today because of a trial. Yes, is it not true? You are caught. There are some people here today in the service because of a problem. Yes. So that problem has made you come nearer to
God.
Yes. Okay, that is why you see some people that are very rich. They have money.
Eh?
But it becomes very difficult for them to go to church. Because they believe that they don't have a... It's very difficult for you to go to a living church. And you see all these heavy rich people there. Is it, do you see them there?
Oh.
They don't have time for church.
Ils n'ont pas le temps pour l'église.
But they have different problems, but as far as money they.
Ils ont des différents problèmes aussi.
It's not that they don't have a problem, but they are serious problems.
Et ils ont des sérieux problèmes autour d'eux.
And that's why Satan takes over them easily.
Et c'est pour cela que Satan prend le dessus sur eux facilement.
Satan does what? Take over them and make them worship him.
Et il les pousse à l'aise à l'adorer.
But I thank God because gradually
Dieu, merci parce que
God is having mercy upon them and bringing them to the church.
Dieu a miséricorde d'eux et les ramène à l'église.
But though when some come to church,
bien que lorsque certains entrent bien à l'église,
they instead want the man of God to leave his position of man of God.
Ils veulent plutôt que l'homme de Dieu laisse sa position.
And instead obey by them.
Et commence à les obéir.
Can that work?
Est-ce que ça peut marcher?
If you are bringing your money to control me,
si vous amenez votre argent pour me contrôler,
does it work?
Est-ce que ça peut marcher?
Mm-mm. You are coming as a money man, I'm coming as a godly man.
Vous venez comme un riche, je viens comme
so
un
you have your office, I have my own.
Donc vous avez votre bureau, j'ai le mien.
Eh? So don't make me drop my office and you continue with your own. Does it work?
Donc ne laissez pas que je quitte mon bureau pour venir dans le vôtre. Est-ce que ça marche?
I'm saying this because many of us in church here are blessed.
And
very rich. So we should not make an error to control the man of God. Listen to what God has said through the man. I will serve God well in truth and spirit in Jesus' name. Because many of my colleagues have gotten problems in their ministries today because men have put them into error. Yes. And since that man of God loves you, loves the things of God, and loves the people of God, he struggles now to satisfy you. And finally find himself in a problem. Me, by his grace, I bet you one person, you better go. Than what million will profit have a problem. That is my character and system that God has given me. One person, if you are angry with me because you don't want to obey what God is telling me to tell you, you better for you and then let million profit godliness in me. Yes, because the Lord made me know that He's making me a father of nations. So I should not compromise with one man and put nations down. If you see, He's making me a father of nations, that means me standing here, I carry nations. Whether your age is what, you carry what? Carry nations. That is how it is. So you become very careful. You become what? Very careful. When God defines who He has made you to be, God has spoken to you. It is now to see that you stand as God has made it to be. If you don't stand like that, you'll find a problem. You find what? Find a problem. Generally, men should not detect in the church. You can have good ideas. You bring them. Those are, I know there are some men of God here. Those are also men of God, their own trial. Christians in the church. Christians in the church are also men of God, their own trial. Because many churches today have had problems because of Christians. Because of what? Christians. Some will see it. They bring ideas to the man. And the man will take them without praying and implement. And when you implement them, trouble. When you were there, just following what God wanted you to be doing.
Alors, avant, tu suivais ce que Dieu voulait que tu fasses.
But Satan come and take some group of people.
Et Satan va amener un groupe de gens.
And bring you wrong ideas.
Qui vont t'amener de mauvaises idées.
And you use the ideas now.
Et tu vas commencer à utiliser
and
ces
God
idées.
Is no more happy with you.
Et Dieu est maintenant mécontent avec toi.
Amen. The duty of the church is also to pray for the man of God.
Le devoir de l'église est aussi de prier pour l'homme de Dieu.
While the man of God is praying for the church,
lorsque l'homme de Dieu prie pour l'église,
the church also pray for them.
Wonderful.
Clap our Lord Jesus Christ. One thing again. Believers don't promote trial among believers. Don't promote what? For example, you can see your brother or your sister going through problems. Don't be scandalizing the person. Rather, you pray for the person. Rather, you know what? Pray for the person. Don't be jubilating in somebody's downfall. Have feeling for the person and you pray for the person's upliftment.
Amen.
Avoid, these are trial issues we are talking about. Avoid putting somebody knowingly into a very complicated situation. If you know that thing is not good for somebody, please make sure you don't take that person into it. That one is called wickedness. It's what? Wickedness. There are some people that have sinned and has gone out of the glory of God. They know whether they have sinned and fallen. But you make sure that you take your brother or your sister and put in the same thing so that both of you should fall knowingly. Rather, you are supposed to come back to God. Repent and God will restore you back. Amen. Than pulling another person into the same thing you are doing. Am I telling somebody here? And believers, for you to avoid too much trial, avoid idleness. Avoid what? Can I talk to somebody? Say, believers, avoid idleness. Idleness means you are not doing anything. So when you are not doing anything, Satan will come and make you to do something. You become a workshop of darkness. This one. Most people that gossip is because of idleness. Am I saying the truth here? Most people that go around gossiping is because of what? Idleness. Since you are not doing anything, you just, Satan come and drop some things in your heart, you just instantly improvise a journey to go to a neighbor, to go to somebody, to go and visit, to go and do this. It is not called for. The Bible says, listen, everybody, the Bible says what? There is no food for a lazy man or woman. There's what? There's no food for a lazy man Believers, develop. Do what? Develop. Change. Don't sit and be idle. Develop and you do what? Change. Pray and God will give you inculcative ideas where you can begin at any smallest level. God will bless the work of your hand. Not be so. God will bless what? The works of your hand. You are praying that God should bless you. Where? How? Work. Work and God will do what? Bless the work of your hand. There are many men that are just there to squander. There are many women that are just there to squander. Please, they are very bad characters that we must cite them here so that believers should repent if you find yourself into that kind of a state, because it is disgracing to the kingdom of God. They are brothers or sisters. They will visit a man who is blessed, a believer who is blessed, because we have the fear of God. And you know that when you ask, they will give. Not be so. They will go here, ask. They will give. They go again there, ask, they will give.
Go
there, ask again, they will give. Go there, ask, just go around being a nuisance to the community of God's people. Is it correct? Oh, if you are not saying no, that means you are one. Is it correct? You go here, the brother will give you either around 50 or 100,000. It is enough to start removing that shame from your head. You go and start something little and be serious, you will grow. You will do what? You will grow. But even the person giving you, you know the way close with the well. Am I talking about here? It's not wearing the kind of dress you are wearing. Yes. As you take that 100,000, now the next shop this, you just enter a shop, then the latest model you will take and wear, he will come and wear you, only the dress is wearing but asking for help. That is a very bad style before God. Is what? Tell your neighbor, never, that style is not good before God. There are people that don't have a calendar of viable people in the church. Today, na Mr. Peter.
Yes.
Tomorrow na Mr. John. Yes. Tomorrow na Madam Mary. Your husband get money. Yes, I fix her. The other day, not this one. If they were not also struggling and God is blessing the work of their hands, you go, guy, you go meet one from. Will you meet one from? God can bless believers, and God is looking for serious believers to bless you. To do what? To bless you. Now, those very people are possessed with the spirit of pride. Yes. They want to receive big money and they don't want to start to a small level. No. Oga, madam, Oga, sir, go and sit and begin to say things of 100,000. They think very big, but they are catching small. And that is how they have been living their life for the past 10 to 20 years. That same lifestyle. Moving and asking something from here to here, asking here. I am not saying you should not help. You can help, you can be a blessing to people, but I am talking of this community of people because I've been hearing a lot and it is disgracing to the kingdom of God. Amen. So let us change. Let us do what? Let us change. Even if you go and somebody give you some amount of money, come back, sit, pray, and let God use you to develop that money. We have seen people that started some things of 10,000, 20,000 francs, and they are big guys today with money. They are. Even women in homes, please try from somewhere. Don't only sit and wait for your husband. Try from somewhere. Help the man to grow. Try from somewhere. As you try from somewhere, God will make you grow. God will make you do what? And when you are busy, woman, when you are busy, there is no place for Satan to use. No way. As you are leaving your house to do that thing, you are busy. You come back, you are in prayer. In the morning, you are in prayer. That is a busy home. You don't have time to be looking at clock. You don't have time to be doing what? Looking at the clock. When the man is supposed to come back at 6 o'clock, he come back at 6, 1 minute past 6, you'll be there outside. Why? Idleness. And the whole day. If you look at all that, the women are not busy and the men are not busy. They are always in total quarrel. They are always in what? Quarreling. Always quarreling. Always what? Quarreling. You get something for do? Do you have anything to do? No, you are doing is talking and talking and talking and talking. Talking to Mary. Mary talk to John. John talk to Mary. Mary talk to John. Are you extending your function anywhere? Extend your function somewhere and you see that there is no trouble. There's no what? Take this teaching and you see that a lot of things will work out in your life in Jesus' name. Women, start somewhere. Men, start somewhere. And look at God. And God will promote you. God will do what? Promote you. And when you are going through a situation, stop calling names. Stop doing what? Stop doing what? Stop calling names. Leave it to God. Say anymore. Leave it to God. Leave it to God. And go into prayer. And then you will have details about that problem. Let me define it to you. Read Jeremiah chapter 33 verse 3 and you'll hear it there. Somebody should read it. Jeremiah 33 verse 3. You will see that when you are in trouble, you don't even know the details of the trouble, but when you pray, God will give you the details of that trouble.
Jeremiah chapter 33 verse 3. Call unto me and I will answer you. I tell you great and unsearchable things you do not know. Amen.
Call on me and I will do what? And when I come, I will do what? I will tell you things that you don't even know about. Amen. French.
Jérémie 33, verset 3. Invoquez-moi et je vous répondrai. Je t'annoncerai de grandes choses et les choses cachées que tu ne connais pas. Amen.
Les choses cachées que tu ne connais même pas. Hidden things. So when you have a problem, then to be talking, calling people's names, stipulating left and right, trying to say, no, Jesus is your key and answer. Amen? Rather go into what? Prayer. And God will answer you. Clap for Lord Jesus Christ. Clap for Jesus again. And the best way for a couple or people to live in a family and live with less trials is when the truth is ruling that community. Is when what? Truth is ruling that community. Ruling that home, ruling that family. If there is truth there, Satan cannot do anything in that place. Then somebody speak the truth. When every environment knows the truth, the truth shall set them free. Always speaking truth. Truth is a very strong weapon. Truth is light. Tell somebody, truth is light. Truth is light. There is always truth in an environment. When there is truth in an environment, that environment becomes so strong and solid. Amen. So because everyone that speaks truth is the child of the truth. Is a child of the truth. The child of God. And God rules that place. But when the environment is lying, they are children of who? Satan. And they will always be trouble. It becomes very dangerous even for you to lie. When you lie, you have called trouble to your own life. Am I telling somebody here? You can lie and go, but you have called trouble to your own life without knowing. He will follow you. Are you hearing? It becomes very bad to lie. Very bad. It is possible to speak truth at all times. Very possible. You know it. You know what is there. Just say just that one and you there. That is the truth. Each time you lie, you have gone under the umbrella of Satan. And trouble will follow you. Trouble will do what? Follow you. That's why some people are facing the trouble they are facing today. You are not fornicating. That one is big sin. You know it. You are not stealing. That one is big sin. You know it. You are not killing. That one is big sin. You know it. That one is alarming. All those ones. But you are using your mouth. There are people that have even lied until lies doesn't mean anything to them. Yes, they just lie them now and they are breathing. Okay, wait. There are two categories of people that lie. There are people that have lied until it doesn't mean anything to them. There are some that lie and say it is wisdom. Are you understanding? So all those ones are liars. Say all those ones are liars. Tell your neighbor, all those are liars. And a lying tongue can never be fruitful. Tell your neighbor, a lying tongue can never be fruitful. Because a lying tongue is a destructive tongue. When you just speak a lie, you are a destroyer. The time, listen. When you speak a lie, you are what? Listen to it. When you send forth a lie, you are destroyed. Because they cannot know the truth there. Then as you have destroyed, you have planted what? A seed of... And that seed of destruction, you must reap it. What you plant, you must do what? What you sow, you must do what? You must reap it. As you lie, you have destroyed and you have planted destruction. So when you sow, you must reap it. So what did you just plant destruction? So you must reap it back to you. Anyway, this sister has stolen. This brother has stolen. Were you there? Anyway, her ways show that she can steal. Were you there? Do you think she can? Her ways show that she can steal. Do you have used wisdom to talk? For which you have just said something directly. Were you there? No. Does she steal? No. To your best knowledge. Finish. You end the thing there. Another one. I don't know why God is bringing this thing, but it is very important. Another thing which you need to know. Please, if a man is always trying to turn talk, do what? If you need to talk straight, and you're always struggling to turn your talk, something is wrong about you somewhere. Something is what? Wrong about you somewhere. Truth is straight, it's not bending. Truth is straight, it's not bending. Somebody would struggle to rap. Finally, that place can never face truth there. Look at all these politicians you see outside. All these people. That's how they talk. They rap. Finally, you are not getting anything from it. Clap for Lord Jesus Christ. Be brief. Talk clear. Say what is there. Save people's time. Over. If I'm talking to you, can I hear a louder amen? Can I hear a louder amen? Secondly, you have done what is wrong. Make sure you should not, when it comes to defend that wrong thing, make sure you own up that you did it. Don't search for a way to defend why you did it. That thing is wrong. Every eye is seeing that is what? It's wrong. When they come and discover it first, pride will come. You don't want that, they should just discover that a whole you have done things like that or that kind of a thing. A whole you. In fact, a whole you, your capacity, has done something like that. No, people should not know I'm the one that did it like that. You take now green color. You want to make people know that is yellow. It can it work? You want to defend and try to turn things and try to bring ideas in it that people should know that what you did is correct and it is like that. You are bringing wrong teachings on earth which are not correct. And by so doing, you are still a liar. If you do what is not right, you made a mistake. You did what? In homes, these are many things that kill couples. Couples and even companies and even communities. You commit an error. It has been discovered. Don't justify. Don't do what? Justify. I did it. I am wrong. I'm sorry. Leave the rest to God. Leave the rest to any man that speaks truth on earth and asks for God forgiveness. You have manifested God. Truth is who? Forgiveness of who? There's no forgiveness in the kingdom of Satan. Yes, I did it. Sorry, something came upon me. I did it. I'm sorry. I did it. Yes, I did it. I'm sorry. Finish. End the story. Leave it to whosoever. If the person is satanic, he will do whatever. If it's God, he will do whatever. But God must defend you.